Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. I have recently decided to redo a load of web challenges. I thought I'm going to create a YouTube series on going through all of the Portswigger labs. One of the reasons why I wanted to do this was because it may give some insight to you on how I approach these sort of challenges, whether it's sort of a technical one or whether it's just sort of the mindset. But I'm going to go through all of the Portswigger labs, starting from SQL Injection, just because it's at the top. I have done some of these already. I will try and approach it from a fresh mind. The reason I've done some of these is because I do it on my stream sometimes, and if you want to catch me live doing them, come follow me on Twitch. The link is in the description. But yeah, follow me on Twitch if you want to. We're going to go through all of these. I'm going to do them one by one. I'm not sure whether I'm going to start with making one video per challenge or whether I'm going to do one video per group. Or maybe I'll split them up. Maybe it'll be, I don't know. We'll find out. See how it goes. I think one video per challenge is going to be a lot. That's a lot of videos. And the description says, this lab contains a SQL injection vulnerability in the product category filter. When the user selects a category, the application carries out a SQL injection that looks like this. Select asterisk, which means everything, from products, where the category is equal to gifts and released equals one. Let's do this. So just load it up. I've already got Burp running. Oh, let me just close a couple of these. Just setting up my keyboard layouts. Right, I've already got Burp installed. So let's just add this URL into our scope. Just paste it into there. What I like to do as well is just tick that one and move it to the top. That means you're just going to intercept requests that are in scope. There's not going to be any other sort of requests that you're intercepting. So I'm going to turn that off for a minute, and we're just going to click through. In fact, well, I've got a better idea. Let's close this, and let's open this browser. Let's do the same thing. Let's go into here. Then everything's set up. I don't need to set up Firefox specifically for this. And to be fair, the built-in browser on Burp is amazing anyway. I'm just going to navigate around. They said it's in the category filters, so these are the category filters by the looks of it. And what we'll do is we'll just click one. And we'll see, hopefully, in here. Yep, we've got a category in here. Cool. So a couple of things I'm going to do. No, thank you. Nope. So I'm going to send one of these to repeater. Oh, that's sequencer. I'm going to send it to repeater. And we'll just send it and see what it says. So we should find here. We've got the name of it here, in fact. So this section, ecoms page header. I'm just going to search for that every time. There's two, but that's fine. So if you click on this little cog here and you click auto scroll to match when text changes, what that means is if I remove this, right, send the request again, it automatically forwards you to here, and you can see that there's no title here, so there's something went wrong. But you don't have to go finding it in the text because it's already there. Anyway, let's go back on this one. So we want to actually add something like an apostrophe here, which would kill the query. So if you have a look at the query again, go back into here and go back to our lab description. You've got this query here. So if I copy this out and I create just any text editor, that's fine. So this is our, in fact, here, let's grab this out, clothing and shoes accessories. So grab that in there. So this is our entry point here. So what we want to do is basically grab everything. So if we put an apostrophe in there, you'd see it break because the query would no longer be valid. We've got two apostrophes there and it doesn't know what to do. So what we actually want to do here is do something like apostrophe or one equals one and then a comment. And the comment will basically clear all of this off. The reason why this is important, well, two things. The reason why the comment's important is so that none of the sort of following code or SQL query gets executed. Similarly, this is important because or one equals one will always be true. So that basically means if you can find this category or just anything, just true, and then that query will return true and it will return everything that's sort of selected in here. So cool, let's go and try that out. So or 1 equals 1. And it did indeed. So we've got all the categories here. Some of them are published, some of them are not published. And if we make that a bit bigger, if we go back, we can actually see, if we go into all, you can take a note of the ones that are here compared to the ones that are in here. And you can see that we've got new ones, like this one here is new. This one, I believe, wasn't there before. So yeah, that's that challenge completed. So if you've learned anything in this video, let me know in the comments. If you want to support the channel, please like the video, comment on the video, subscribe to my channel. I'm going to try and release at least 3 or 4 of these videos every week, depending on my time and everything else. Obviously, I work full time. But with any luck, I want 3 or 4 of these videos gone out a week, and I want to cover off everything that I can within the WebSec Academy. So yeah, anyway, take it easy.